What is the best scale for reselling? Need to weigh your items for Poshmark, eBay, Mercari, ThredUp? In today's video, I'm gonna share with you which scale I think is the absolute best for reselling, and I've tried a bunch. I'll give you my honest review. What's up, resellers? I'm Rebecca, and you're watching Rebecca the Reseller. My channel is all about Poshmark selling tips, so if you wanna know how to sell on Poshmark, make sure you subscribe. Okay, let's get into the review. So, story time. I think I have had probably now at this point about 4 or 5 different scales over the course of the last 5 years of me reselling. And I can tell you that some definitely do the trick. And when you're just starting out, it's definitely good to just not spend a lot of money until you start to make some money. I totally get that. But if you know that Poshmark or eBay or Mercari or ThredUp and reselling in general is going to be your thing and this is what you do, it really does help save time and effort, frustration. In the long run, hopefully earn you more money if you have the right tools right at the beginning. So I'm actually gonna share with you just a couple of things that I learned about buying scales and then the two that I actually have right now currently. So first, when I started reselling, I started with a kitchen scale from Walmart and I think it was like $10 or $12 and it was really not meant to be a postal scale or weighing of a scale for measuring like the weight of clothing items, which is what I sell. It was really meant for like measuring the ounces of food to put in a recipe, but it did the trick. You know, it had a small little place where you could put the item. It had a very small reader. It ran on batteries, so you had to constantly reset it all the time. And so if you're just starting out and that's what you have in your house, I definitely think it's great to use something that you already have. But if you don't have anything at all and you are going to start selling on eBay or somewhere where you need the weight of the item, I don't even think you should bother with that type of scale because you're going to basically outgrow it. It's going to frustrate you. There's going to be a lot of downside to it. And I just don't think it's worth spending the $10 or $12 to get a cheap scale. I think you should put that $10 or $12 plus a little bit more to one that is actually going to stay with you in the long run. So the next type of scale that I went to was a bigger surface area. It had a nice rectangle and it had the reader inside the weighing area. And so that was great for a time. And then I learned my lesson on that. One, it was still battery operated. And so you'd have to keep resetting it. It would kind of go to sleep after a little while and that got frustrating. It made some beeping noises every time you did that. That got annoying. And I realized that for certain things, it was hard to see the reader the way it was laid out inside the surface area. So it was like one big flat thing and then it had the reader. And so that wasn't ideal for me. And when I hired a photographer, I gave her that one as like a second option that she could use. And then I bought myself another one. And so my third and final scale for this purpose is this. It's the AccuTech, and I will put a screenshot up of it and I will link it down below so that you can see the exact one. But this works wonders. So the reason why I like this is because even though it has a smaller surface area here, the black part, than the one I had previously, it's all I really needed because the reader was separate from it. And so you could easily put an item on it and it would work just fine. You could still see the reader. And so for me, that worked really well. Even if you had a big jacket in one of my larger bags that is like this size, you can still put that on here and you can still visibly see the reader. So for me, that worked out really well. Now, another reason why I liked it is it does go up to 50 pounds. And so when I started in ThredUp, I was able to still put my 30 pound boxes on here. And so I'll talk about that more in a minute, but I did like the fact that it did go up to 50 pounds. Also, it had this hold button. So if you had something that was large that covered up the reader when you put it on, you could press this hold button and it would keep the weight on the screen. And then when you took the item off so you could read the screen, you would be able to see what the weight was. So if I put a giant box on here and I couldn't see the screen, I'd press the button and there would be the reader when I took the box off and I could now see the screen. So I liked that. Probably the biggest feature that I like about this that really, you know, sometimes it's not about like all the bells and whistles, it's just about the simple things that save you frustration and that is all worth it. And what saved caused me a lot of frustration was it can be battery operated, but it has the AC adapter. I think that's what it's called. But you can plug it into the wall. So you plug it in back here, and then you plug it into the wall, which I'm not gonna do. And so what happens is that in between items, as you're photographing and weighing and photographing and weighing, when you're on battery mode, it will shut off and you have to turn it back on again. And then you have to wait for it to boot up, and it takes a couple of seconds. And every time it takes a couple of seconds, you're like feeling like your brain cells are dying. So for me, having it plugged into the wall while I'm using it over a period of time of batch doing photography and weighing, it doesn't turn off. So it saves so much time. You don't have to keep pressing the button. It's just so helpful. Like, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about if you've used a scale and it keeps shutting off in between doing your items and photographing an item and then weighing it. It's so frustrating. So for me, having the AC adapter like does the trick. This alone is the reason why I like this scale. So when I'm weighing Poshmark packages, eBay packages, or Mercari packages, this is the one. Now, I have used this for thread up, but when I really started getting into thread up, I did start to get frustrated with the small surface area. And I knew that there was a better way, because even though you could press the hold button, it was still really cumbersome. So then I upgraded my thread up for this Mama Jamma. So this is the surface area to weigh the item. And so it's obviously a nice big square, but then it has the detached reader. So it hooks up here. It has the detached reader. You can turn it on and put it far away so that when you put a large box here, you can still see the readout without pressing hold or doing anything crazy. And so this one, it can go up to capacity 200 kilograms. So I don't know what that is, but it does give you kilograms and all of that stuff on here. But again, it is battery operated. It doesn't plug into the wall. But here's the thing. When you're doing thread up packages, it's not a constant thing. Like, you're weighing a package, it could go off. You've got to pack up your package, do all the tape. Like, it's a bigger box. It's not like you're doing clothing item, take a few photos, put it in your bag and weigh it. It's just a different process. So for me, not having it be on all the time is totally fine with me. I can turn it on, put the big box on it, do what I need to do, turn it back on again, put another big box on it. Like, that's no problem. That is not frustrating. But with the other one for Poshmark packages and things, that is frustrating every time you're weighing an item. So for me, this one here does the trick for thread up. And I thought about it. I'm like, do I really need two scales? Like, am I that person that must have every single kind of gadget? And normally I'm not. I'm really not a gadget person, but I am of the mind of working smarter and not harder, and recognizing the business operations that I'm doing. And if there's a need for a specialized machine or piece of equipment that's going to help that particular task happen stress-free, faster, easier, time is money, especially when you're a one-woman show. And so for me, having two scales is okay. And I actually have the smaller scale for my Poshmark packages here at home, because that's where I do my photography. And then I actually have the thread up scale at my storage unit, because that's where I pack up my thread up boxes, because that's where I do all my sorting. Now for you, if you do everything at home, that's okay. You can have both scales at home, but you're probably gonna do different things at different times. It's not like you're gonna have two scales out on your desk all the time and now you have no space to do anything else. Like, it's not gonna work like that. You can put your thread up scale away and not have to worry about it. And you can have your Poshmark and eBay and Mercari scale out, because you're gonna do that more often. Also, I'm not an Amazon FBA seller, but if you're thinking about becoming an Amazon FBA seller, this thread up scale, that's what I call it my thread up scale. This thread up scale will do the trick for you for Amazon FBA as well, because you're gonna be packing big boxes just like I do for thread up. So I call it a thread up scale because I'm not into Amazon FBA, maybe someday. But if you are like Poshmark, eBay, Mercari, and now you're gonna start dabbling in Amazon FBA, that scale would be perfect for you. So you still may want to consider both. Okay, that's my honest review of both scales. I don't wanna pick one. I like having them both. You may want to pick one or the other based on your business operations and what you're gonna be doing with it. I encourage you to check out the links down in the description below to send you to Amazon to use my affiliate link and purchase one for yourself. I do appreciate it. And leave me a comment below and let me know which scale you like. You you have it already? Is there another better one out there that I don't know about? Let me know in the comments below. Did you know that I put together a lot of reseller resources for you? I spend a lot of time putting everything together. I include it down in the description below for free, and it's everything I recommend. I hope you will check it out today. Thanks so much for joining me for this video. I hope you pick up a scale that you like based on the recommendations that I've made. I wish you all the best of luck with your sales, and go ahead and check out whatever video comes up next. I appreciate it. Bye!